Hey everyone, Liv here from Hypotenuse AI. I think we can all agree that writing well-substantiated content can be super time-consuming. If you're looking for reliable information to build out your content briefs, that's where our content detective research tool comes into play. In this video, I'll walk you through how you can use Content Detective to easily search for real-time facts and statistics, then using them as talking points to create content, as well as get sources for those facts. It'll speed up the way you create content 10 times faster. First off, you can do this by building the outline that you want. You can either do this by generating different outline ideas, as well as combining them to build that outline, or you can add a heading here and type in the heading that you want. Once it's done, you can start researching by selecting what outlines you want to research for. Where Content Detective comes in the most handy is with headings that requires any statistics or numbers, or it's news that the AI might not have known about. So in this case, I think that these two headings are pretty appropriate and the AI might not have information on what just happened in the World Cup finals. So go ahead and start researching for these. What's happening now is that Content Detective uses advanced algorithms to scour the internet and provide you with a summary, almost like a dossier of the topic, including reliable and up-to-date sources. So here we can see it's given us some information on who won, where it happened. And you can see here that it's provided some sources from me as well. If I click onto any of these, it'll bring me to the page where this content was extracted from. And I can use these links either as a citation or as a backlink in my final content. In addition to the facts and statistics provided by Content Detective, you can also add in your own talking points and ideas to supplement the research. So in this case, I might want to say that allocators really dislike wet feet. Wet feet, don't overwater them. This helps to bring in your own experience and opinions that will help create useful content that's a combination of both AI assistance as well as your own history and experience. So now that we have an outline that we want, we can go ahead and generate the article itself. Over here, you can see that I have my full outline here, and there's an option for me to generate this article, which I'll go ahead and generate. What our AI will now do is to take these talking points that you've both researched as well as included your own talking points for and weave them into the paragraphs themselves. Let's take a look. So first off, we can see the paragraphs that we included some talking points for. So soil should be one part soil and one part perlite or core sand and fertilized monthly. In this case, well, I'll give you some time to read this through. But you can see here that it mentions adding one part perlite or core sand and fertilizing on a monthly basis. It's the same for the section on watering the plant itself. So you can see here that 25% to 50% is the recommendations. And that has been actually woven into the paragraph itself. It's not just lifting a talking point itself, but it's taking that and using it as a base for what the content could be and adding more details and making it more readable. After you've generated your paragraphs and you feel that you might want to add on more content, you can always go back and do more research on more paragraphs or add new paragraphs and research for them, or to add in any talking points that you don't think have been appropriately covered in your article. So for instance, we can look at this section on common mistakes. Looks like the AI is telling us to avoid direct sunlight. That makes a lot of sense. Your leaves will burn in direct sunlight. Don't keep the plant in drafty spots and don't overwater the plant. Maybe here, from my own experience, I know that allocators also are very prone to mealybugs, and that's a common mistake that most people make. Similarly, I can add a talking point here and I can say, you know, watch out for mealybugs, very common. for alopecias. If I want more content on this, I can now go ahead and just select this and regenerate just this section and paragraph. When you regenerate, you'll find the new content at the bottom of the article itself. So here you can see it's rewritten that paragraph and it's telling me, yes, it doesn't get sun, you know, and there's a bit about mealybugs here. So if I want to combine this content, I'll just move this over back to common mistakes. And I'll combine this because I think this is a nice transition. This is maybe a bit of a overlap with this section on sunlight. So what I might want to do is to, however, don't forget to get them in the sun as well. Once I combine this, I have here a well-defined and accurate paragraph on some common mistakes on alocasias. So that's it on our content detective tool. You'll find that it's not always necessary to use it for every single heading and paragraph, as our AI already has a good knowledge of topics as a whole. However, for anything that is a new topic that the AI might not have information about, especially if it's just happened recently, or if you're looking for some facts and statistics, as well as the sources to back them up, this is where Content Detective comes really in handy. So that's all, and let me know if you have any thoughts or feedback.